In this video, I will explain what is the VPC and how to change some elements or settings to get the most informative plot. The VPC, or Visual Predictive Check, is a diagnostic plot that offers an intuitive assessment of misspecification in structural, variability, and covariate models. The principle is to assess graphically whether the model is representative of the data that were used to estimate it. To check this, the model is used to resimulate many times the initial dataset. The difficulty is then to compare the results of the simulations to the dataset. One way to do this is to split the observations in different intervals and compare for each interval three points that represent the distribution of the data. These are the blue curves, and they are called empirical percentiles and summarize the observed data. The blue and pink areas are the prediction intervals, and they summarize the predictions from the model. I will now show on this example how these different elements are computed. In display, I can hide or overlay some elements on the plot. To explain how the empirical percentiles and prediction intervals are obtained, I will begin by hiding them and add the observed data that appear now as blue dots. These are the pool data for all IDs. The goal in the VPC is to summarize this data. To this end, the time axis is first split in several intervals or bins so that the observations in each bin will be pulled into representative values. The bin limits can be displayed with this button. Then in each bin, the 10th, 15th and 19th percentiles are calculated for the data in the bin. They are represented with these blue dots, located in the center of the bins and linked with blue segments. This means that in the first bin, for example, the lowest dot here is the 10th percentile. It is the value above 10% of the observations in the bin. The second dot is the median, so it is above 50% of the observations in the bin. Finally, the highest dot is the 19th percentile, and 90% of the observations are below this value. Thus, after hiding the observed data, these percentiles still provide a summary of the distribution of the observations in each bin. The goal of the VPC is then to compare the predictions from the model to this data. So a large number of Monte Carlo simulations are performed with the model and the design structure of the original dataset. So the same dosing, same measurement times and number of samples, and same covariates. By default, 500 simulations are done, but this can be changed in the settings of the task plots. For each simulation, the same percentiles are computed across the same bins as for the empirical percentiles. Prediction intervals for each percentile are then estimated across all simulated data and displayed as color areas. I will first choose a display without a linear interpolation to better understand what is going on. The pink area is the 90% prediction interval for the median. So for each bin, this is the area where the median of the observations is located for 90% of the simulations. In the same way, the blue areas are the areas where the 10th percentile or the 90th percentile is located for 90% of the simulations. By default, the prediction intervals are displayed not as rectangles like here, but they are linked across adjacent bins with linear interpolation to get a continuous area over time, like this. That way, they can be compared more easily to the empirical percentile curves. The bin limits are also hidden by default. So the model has a high predictive power with respect to the observed data if, like here, the median empirical curve falls within the pink area and the lower and upper empirical curves fall in the lower and upper blue areas. Discrepancies between prediction intervals and empirical curves are highlighted with red dots and red areas. For example, if I zoom in here, the 10th empirical percentile in the last bin is slightly above the corresponding prediction interval, which means that it is higher than the 10th percentile computed for 90% of the simulations. So the lowest observations at high times are slightly underpredictive. In addition to selecting or hiding some elements from the plot, the settings panel can be used to change the levels for the percentiles in display. The level here is the percentage of simulation used to compute each prediction interval, so it is reflected by the width of the prediction intervals. By default, the level is 90%. The value of the higher percentile can also be modified, and it will affect the upper and lower percentiles computed both from the data and in the prediction intervals. For example, I can choose the 95th percentile if I want to check if extreme observations are also taken into account by the model. In beans, it is also possible to change the beans on the time axis. Of course, to represent well the data, the observation times have to be segmented into coherent subsets across the beans. Two simple binning strategies are available to divide the observation times: beans with equal width on the axis, or with equal size, that is, with the same number of observations. By default, a more complex strategy called least squares criteria computes the bin limits automatically to minimize heterogeneity of data in each bin. The number of bins is also automatically computed by default, like this, but I can choose a fixed number of bins instead, like this. Note that if you split the VPC, the number of bins is adapted to each subplot. For example, the VPC for the PK of remifentanil with an increased number of bins shows an irregular curve for the 19th empirical percentile. Adding the observed data, colored by dose group, shows that this is due to the high observed data corresponding to large doses. In such cases, a prediction correction has been proposed in the literature to maintain the diagnosis value of a VPC and can be applied with this button. This formula is then applied. In each bin, the observed and simulated data are normalized based on the typical population prediction for each individual at the median time in the bin and the median of typical population predictions for all individuals. The aim is to remove in each bin the variability coming from variations in independent variables to focus on the variability coming from the random effect. If I check the prediction correction, the variability in each bin due to the different doses is reduced, and after hiding the observed data, the VPC is much easier to read. This is it for this video. Note that we will release shortly another video on advanced usage of the VPC, such as how censored observations are handled or how to regenerate a VPC in Simulix to take a dropout into account.